I believe that you start at the top. Why do we start at the top? Well, two reasons why. Number one, your warmest air is always at the ceiling. So if we can save the warmest air in the house, we can get the best savings. Number two is that old bugaboo, the stack effect. If hot air rises and it can find an easy path out, it's going to exit the house, thereby drawing colder air in from lower levels of the home. So that's why we say attic or ceilings are number one. That's the first priority. All right, now, oops. I never did hit the button, did I? Oh, yes, I did. What was I talking about? Okay, this first picture here is the one thing that I tend to run into more frequently than any other ceiling air leak, the attic access. That's that square hole that's cut in the ceiling so that you can go up into the attic. And quite often that access just has a little board. This was actually a piece of drop ceiling that they were using to seal this attic. And if you look around here, you can see all the gap that is letting cold air escape or heated air escape into the attic. Now, how to fix that sort of thing? Well, if you've never had any intention of going up in the attic, maybe what you can do is go ahead and caulk this thing shut. All right? I myself like to use a removable caulk. Can you get a picture of this? All right, this is a removable caulk, and quite frequently I will caulk attic accesses shut with removable caulk. That way, if something should happen, like a light fixture goes bad in the ceiling and you got to get up there and fix it, or there's a leak that's occurring from the roof and you got to figure out where it is, well, you can just remove this caulk and get up there into the attic. So that's one way of fixing that. Another way would be using weather stripping, maybe something like this peel and press foam weather stripping, and weather strip the edges, and then a hook and eye to kind of hold that hatch down and into place and tightly seal on the weather stripping. Okay, so